In the last video, we learned how to make sprites and other things to make a ping pong game. In this video, we are going to learn how to add sound effects and animation to that game. To add a sound effect, here I am using an if command. When the ball touches top edge or the bottom edge or the player pedal or the computer pedal, then a certain sound effect will play. So to do so, I am using the or function inside the if parenthesis. The code is visible on the screen and you can see it. So here I am using play sound function, which is predefined in code.org. So whenever you will select the play sound function, you will get the choose option where you can choose any sound effect that you like from their inbuilt library. So you can see whenever the ball touches any of the top edge, bottom edge, player pedal or the computer pedal, it plays a sound. Now this is the animation tab. Here you can see I have added few animations. You can also add your animation by clicking on new animation or selecting any one of them. So I am going to use those animations on this game. I will set animation to computer pedal by using dot set animation and just giving the name of the animation in the parenthesis. Same with the player pedal, dot set animation parenthesis and the name of the animation. If you want to reduce the scale of the animation, you can just write variable name dot scale is equal to any certain amount that you want. 1 is the original size, below 1 will make the size smaller, and above 1 will enlarge the size of the animation. You can see here I have reduced the size of the ball. Now I will also reduce the size of the player pedal to make it equal to the computer pedal. You can see the size of the computer pedal and the player pedal are now equal. The game is working smoothly. So we will change the background also. So we will make another variable before all the variables, as we want it to be at the background. So we will make it at the top of all the variables. So I have created a sprite named BG, and here I will set the animation of BG to a soccer field. You can see now the background has changed to soccer field, but the text is not there, the score text that we added. So to do so, we will bring it outside the draw sprite function. Means the draw, after drawing sprites, then it will show the text. Means on above the background, it will show the text. The stroke function is used to give a certain color to the text, so I will use that function, stroke, and in the parenthesis using the inverted commas I will give the name of the color. I will use black color here. You can see the text is became visible to us, and I have increased the size also. The game is working smooth. Now here I am making a variable to show you how to make any sprite invisible or visible. So I am making two sprites named so here are both sprites, border 1 and border 2. So to make any sprite visible or invisible, we use dot visible function in the draw function. So we will write the name of the variable, the sprite, then dot visible is equal to false means invisible is equal to true means visible. Default, without writing the code, it is visible only, but whenever we write is equal to false, that makes the sprite invisible. But the sprite is there and it will work if we put any command on that. You can see the both the borders have become invisible, but to check whether they are there or not, I will show you dot bounce off function. Whenever the ball goes to this border, it will bounce back. So to check that, it is a nice trick to check whether the borders are there or not. You can see the ball is bouncing back from there, means the sprites are there. just removing it because we did not need this in our game. So just removing that, all those things. Now the main thing is that now we will change the mouse Y, means using the mouse to control the player paddle, to using the arrow keys on the keyboard. So we will not use the mouse Y, we will use the keyboard arrow keys. You can use any of the keys to set those things, but I will use the arrow keys. I will write 4 if commands for up, down, left and right. In that if commands, they all will be separate if commands. In the if command for up, I will write player paddle dot y is equal to player paddle dot y minus a certain amount. So I will use key down function. So in down I will use player paddle dot y is equal to player paddle dot y plus a certain amount. In left, player paddle dot x is equal to player paddle dot x minus a certain amount, and again in right, player paddle dot x is equal to player paddle dot x plus a certain amount. So this is how we write the code for using the keys to play a game, and this all thing will go inside the game state play only. Before we are going to game state play, nothing will work. So on the screen you can see the codes, how I am changing those by copy paste. Just see on the screen there. You can see all those things are working fine. I can use the key, but here is the glitch I have found, that if I put the left key, press the left key, the player paddle will go to another side of the game. So to do so, I will write an if command. If player paddle dot x is going less than 4, let's say 240, then it will again come to 240. Means if player paddle will go beyond 240, means on the left side, it will again come to the certain position. You can see, but here is also a glitch. Let me change the amount. Now the player paddle will not go there. So now let's make the game harder by increasing the velocity of the ball. Yeah, now the game has become harder, the ball is going faster. But I have found another glitch, that the player paddle is going outside the ground, means on the right side, above and below. So we will make another, I will use another function which is named collide, then player paddle dot collide top edge, then again another code for dot collide bottom edge, then another code for collide right edge. Now you can see the player paddle is not going upwards, means not beyond the boundaries. Same I will use for bottom edge and for the right edge. Now if the game state is equal, then the player paddle will be set to another animation which is false, means whenever the computer will score a point, then the player paddle will fall down. You can see, whenever the player computer paddle scores a point, the player paddle falls. It is working fine. But whenever we will press the space bar, then the player paddle should come again to the origin, means at the center of the goal. I have put all those key pressed on function to play game state, means only in the game state play we can move the player paddle. Now I will change the thing, means whenever we will press the space key, the player paddle will come again to the center position of the goal. Now we have made another sound effect whenever the ball goes outside the boundaries of player paddle. Whenever the computer paddle scores, it plays a sound. Now वी आर मेकिंग द विनिंग स्क्रीन मीन्स वेन एवर द कंप्यूटर स्कोर्स पॉइंट 5 points, then the game will stop and the computer pedal will win and a trophy will become visible on the left side on the computer pedal side. So if game state is equal to end, we will make a variable, a sprite for the award, and in the animation we will select another animation from the library. So I will select the second trophy.